Today we are going to be starting the third admin panel in our Laravel multi-authentication series. First, we built one from scratch so that we could see some of the parts that go into making it work. Then we used the admin LTE theme to have a nicer front end. And now we're going to step up our game and use Voyager to let it do the heavy lifting for us. I really like this package, especially for bigger projects, because once it's set up and configured, it makes things so much easier and you can customize it and make it work how you would like. It uses the Blade templating engine, which, as I mentioned at the end of the Admin LTE series, might be a better fit when it comes to having a front end and a back end for projects. Under the hood, it uses Bootstrap. Now, if you want to skip ahead to the demo, I'm leaving the timestamp for it in the description and the comments. So here's the thing. I wanted to make the entire app with Bootstrap, but unfortunately I was unsuccessful and it did not turn out as well as the project with Admin LTE. While I was working on this Voyager project, some of you mentioned you were having a problem with using Jetstrap for your projects. I came across the problem and discovered a few things. With Laravel's recent release, Jetstrap doesn't work with the current version of Inertia. So you would have to basically downgrade some parts of the app. Now, in the Admin LTE project that I did, all of those versions of everything that we had works. So if you still want to do that project and get it working how we got it to work, you would have to definitely use the last known, which is, to my knowledge, the versions of everything that I used, whether it was in the composer.json or the package.json. That is entirely up to you. Now, the Admin LTE project, that project I was able to clone and I got it up and running just fine, but that was, again, the last known, as far as I'm aware of, set of packages and versions that work together just perfectly fine. After that, things get a little wonky. Now, even if you were to set the Inertia version to 3.4.6, or I think that's what it was, 3.4.6. If you were to change that in the composer.json and the composer lock, then you would get past the Jetstrap error. But then you would have to deal with the next error, which is going to come up, which is the SAS problem. Okay, so I want you to take a look real quick to kind of get an idea of what I'm talking about. So this is if you were migrating to version 5. So if you were going to do it with the Jetstrap, you would have to, that Jetstrap, I believe, installs 4.6. After you do that, you would have to still upgrade to version 5, which is, I believe, it's the current stable version of Bootstrap. It's a big change. I'm going to leave all these links in the description down below so you can see what I'm talking about. But we'll just take a quick look. This is if you were migrating to version 5, meaning you've already have the previous version of 4.6, and then you now need to upgrade again to the version 5 because a lot's changed. Okay, so they've dropped jQuery for one, they've upgraded the Popper JS, which is fine, but then they replaced libsass with dartsass as the sass compiler, and then migrated from Jekyll to Hugo for building the documentation. Okay, so they've dropped Internet Explorer, they dropped a whole bunch of different browsers, okay? There's some changes to the documentation. Now, if we head to the main culprit of this, which is SAS, you can look. I'll scroll down so you can take a quick look, or pause it so you can read them as I go along, but these are all breaking changes. All of them are breaking changes. Every single one of them, breaking changes. Content, RTL, forms, even components, badges. This is a lot of change, okay, which ordinarily wouldn't be a problem, but if there's another way to do it, then maybe this isn't the best option for Laravel right now. And as I say, I always say, whatever project you're following, whether it's mine or another developer, you're watching tutorials left and right, and they at least share their code with you like I do, go and take a look at the packages. If they're doing something that you want to do, go and take a look at the composer and the composer.json and the package.json for the versions that they're using. If you start running into errors, because 9 times out of 10, that's the problem. If it's not some sort of user like maybe you typed in the wrong letter, because that happens to me all of the time. So if you type in the wrong letter and just everything just sort of breaks, then definitely take a look at, you know, if it's not that, you double checked all of your personal work, just go ahead and take a look at the versions, because that could potentially be what the problem is. And any Laravel Bootstrap tutorial that you're watching right now, I'm assuming is having a similar problem. And I noticed that some people were skipping through the problem because these pop up and these pop up as deprecations, and you can change them. You can change some of them. So this is how I was able to get through, because I was working on it. I've been working on it for a few days, but this breaking change is the slashes division is a big one that pops up, and it comes up in your terminal, and you can click it and it'll take you to this page. Okay, the error is breaking changes slash dot slash div or dash div. Okay, and this shows you how to install this SAS migrator. This installs it globally, and then you would just type in SAS migrator, you know, all the rest of this, and this will change up some of the problems that you might be having. Now, this will help along the way, but again, use this at your own caution. So that's my little take on it. Okay, now the project that we're working on, as I said, Voyager is built with Bootstrap. It uses Bootstrap in its own sort of ecosystem, so it has its own versions of absolutely everything, and everything works out of the box. So even if you had a project where you were using Bootstrap throughout the whole app, it wouldn't even touch what's going on in the Voyager portion of it. Okay, it wouldn't even matter. The other thing I like about it is that they maintain it and keep it up. So without further ado, let's go ahead and take a look at what we have here. So how I did this was with, we have Laravel, we have Inertia, we have Jetstream, all of that is on the front end. And so our admin panel is on the back end, which means that I can type admin@admin.com password. Okay, and then we are taken straight to the admin route. Again, this is a route within Voyager. So now you see here, we have three, these are called widgets, okay? And this widget is coming from our user model. This post is coming from the Voyager post model, which we could use our own. If we wanted to, we could create a whole other widget, but I just left these as default so you could see them. They're fine. And then pages. Okay, so let's just click on one of these just to see what it looks like. Okay, and this is just a regular page. Okay, we can even view it. Hello world, title, active. This would probably be something more for the developer role that we have, but the admin and the super admin have access to this page. And I think the moderator, I think they all do actually, but this is one of the few that the developer can look at. Okay, and this is where they would take a look at all the info and see what's in our database that they can change. Okay, we've got the excerpt, the body. This thing even has, this is the page, the image that's in our, it's in our app, but the link to it is in our database. So this works right out of the box, installing, updating, or uploading media. Okay, and we can even go to, this is again from our user model. So these are user images, and their media loader actually uses intervention image, which means that we can customize the sizes that we put in, and it would just adjust it just right. So we can give it multiple sizes and we can use them for different parts of the app. Okay, so this is our default image that we have for our users. And why don't we go ahead and take a look at the users table. Okay, and now we have, these are all the users that we have. I didn't create an admin table for it, but all of them are just sort of integrated together with the standard users as well. But you can adjust that, obviously, however you'd like. Okay, so that's pretty much all I just wanted to give you guys a little bit of a gist of what we were doing, and everything, like I said, is customizable, and you'll be able to see the difference when we actually start to install the package. Okay. The other thing you can do, last thing I want to show you, is that we changed up the redirect for the logout. Okay, so now if we click, we also have a profile for the admins. So it's its whole little ecosystem, really. I quite like this package. Okay, and as you can see, it's now brought us back to the very first landing page that's shown for unauthenticated users. Okay, so I'm going to leave it there for now. In the next episode, we're going to start building this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.